and thereby in this way we will be able to distinguish between a plant cell and animal cell. So first of all, starting with the structure of plant cell, the main difference between the structure of a plant cell and animal cell is that in case of plant cell, our cell wall is present. बिल्कुल outside के ऊपर cell के outside cell wall present हो गया. Okay, this is the cell wall. Cell wall is representing the outer covering of the cell and it is made up of the cellulose. Cellulose is a carbohydrate. Cellulose is a carbohydrate material which provides rigidity to the cell wall. Then the cell membrane comes. This is the cell membrane after the cell wall. Cell membrane is also known as the plasma membrane of the cell. And this large structure that you are seeing in this cell is the vacuole. Vacuole is a single membrane bound structure which is here in the plant cell to store the excess of the water sap in the cell. And after this, the main organelle, which is nucleus of the cell, it is controlling the entire activity inside the cell. For example, here the nucleolus is present, nucleoplasm is here inside the nucleus, and outside the nucleus, endoplasmic reticulum is there. And the function of this endoplasmic reticulum is to form the proteins inside the cell. And these are the blastules present inside the plant cell. Chloroplasts is a special type of the plastid which is present inside the plant cell and it is helping the cell in the photosynthesis. And this is the Golgi apparatus. And Golgi apparatus is helping the plant cell to package the proteins which are being synthesized by endoplasmic reticulum. These proteins are packaged by Golgi apparatus. And there are so many functions that are being performed by Golgi apparatus inside the cell. For example, the formation of the complex sugars from the simple sugars. So this is the mitochondria inside the cell, and mitochondria is also known as the powerhouse of the cell as it is involved in the synthesis of the energy in the form of ATP inside the cell. Because mitochondria has certain kinds of oxidative enzymes in it, and these enzymes just convert the food inside the cell into the energy, and it is stored in the form of ATP. So now coming to the animal cell, this is the outer boundary, outer wall of the cell called cell membrane or plasma membrane. These are the lysosomes, and these lysosomes are absent in case of plant cells. These are present in case of only in animal cells. This is mitochondria again, and it is present in both plant and animal cell because it is the powerhouse of the cell. Similarly, nucleus is present in both of the cells, either it is a plant cell or it is an animal cell. This is the cytoplasm of the cell. Cytoplasm is representing the matrix or the gel-like medium inside the cell in which all the cell organelles are being embedded. Then this is the endoplasmic reticulum which is present near the nucleus. And note one thing here that these are the two types of endoplasmic reticulums are of under two types, rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. In case of rough endoplasmic reticulum, ribosomes are present on its surface. As you can clearly see that these ribosomes are present on the surface of RER, and these ribosomes are helping the cell to synthesize the proteins. Therefore, ribosomes are part protein factories of the cell. And what about SCR? SCR is helping in the formation of the proteins, lipids and the fats inside the cell. So let's differentiate these two cells. First of all, the size of the plant cell is about 10 to 100 μm, and which is quite larger than that of the size of the animal cell. Then coming to the cell wall, which is present in case of animal cell, which is absent in case of animal cell, but it is present in case of plant cells. Okay, absent in animal cell. Then coming to the chloroplast, it is present in plant and absent in animal cell. Then the shape of the plant cell is generally regular, but the shape of animal cell is generally the irregular. And then coming to the stored form of energy. Stored form of energy in case of plant cells is the starch, and in case of animal cells it is glycogen. Then coming to the lysosomes. Lysosomes are absent in case of plants and they are present in case of animals. Vacuoles. Vacuoles, a very large size vacuole is present in case of plant cell, and in case of animal cell it is either present or it is absent or it is present in the small size, in the form of small size. So that's it about the difference between plant cell and animal cell. Thank you.